trying to slim down or tone up, you could be making some big mistakes that are actually sabotaging your success and causing you to gain weight, which is very frustrating. Not to worry. Here to help fix some of the most damaging diet and fitness faux pas is Men's Health magazine contributor David Jack. Welcome, David.
Thank you, thank you.
All right, so let's talk, because I think there are a lot of common mistakes and misconceptions about how you get in shape, lose weight, or, you know, get healthier in general.
Yes.
And one common mistake is people cut too many calories. They try to really, you know, stay away from food too much.
Yeah, and there are so many problems with that. And when we try to cut calories and we're really drastic with that, we actually can change the way our metabolism works. We can change the way that we respond to food. And some of those things, physiologically and emotionally, can take a long time to unwind. When we cut our calories so deep, our body doesn't get the nutrition that it needs to be healthy. And so we really have to be careful with deep starvation diets, because they just don't work.
So what is a good guideline for calorie intake?
So a good guideline, there's a simple equation that we've been able to put up for them called the Harris-Benedict equation. And so basically what that does, it looks at what your basal metabolic rate is, which depends on your age and some other factors that you have specifically for you. Then it looks at your activity, and it'll give you different charts if you're moderately active, if you're vigorously active, and that will help you identify how many calories you need to take in on any given day to maintain your current body weight. If you want to lose weight, we don't recommend anyone go below 1,000 calories unless a doctor recommends it or you're fasting for a specific reason.
Right.
But we would ultimately say I was 230 and I wanted to be 210. I would look at the number 210, I'd go to 2,100 calories, I'd factor in my activity, and that would work from there. Longer term safe changes.
All right, the next diet destroyer is when you go low fat. And I've learned a lot about this because I did a documentary called Fed Up. And basically, they say that it may be low fat, but when they take out the fat, they add a lot of other stuff. So now I don't even buy anything that's low fat.
You know what? Low fat doesn't necessarily mean healthy. And like you said, it's so right. When we're taking out fat and we're taking out calories, we have to replace it with something. And unfortunately, what we've done is we've replaced it with, I mean, I'm looking at the back of this, there's 50 ingredients, probably 30 of them I can't really pronounce. And we're putting things in that are just not good for our bodies.
A lot of times it's sugar, because if you look at low-fat salad dressings, it may have half the fat, but often it has double the sugar.
It's sugars, it's processed foods. I mean, the last time I looked, there aren't any Pop-Tart plants or Twinkie trees floating around.
Right, right.
Natural by design, healthy, healthy things, that's what's good for us.
How many grams of fat can the average woman eat to maintain a healthy weight?
So, you know, that's what's interesting. It varies by individual and by age and by size and by body weight and body fat, but we look at it as a total percentage of your food intake. So there's three fuels: protein, fat, and carbohydrates. And there are people who can take in 50% of their calories through fats and be really healthy and really lean. Good fats actually help burn fat.
And let's talk about those good fats, like avocado.
Avocados, you've got grass-fed butters, you have lean proteins, you have fats in eggs. So a lot of those omega-3, some omega-6, you know, the chia seeds, some seeds and nuts, there are really good fats that we need in our body to stay healthy and to have proper brain function and proper organ function.
All right, then there's something called beverage blindness. What is that?
So beverage blindness, the average American, 25 to 30% of our caloric intake comes in from liquids. And here's the thing with liquids, the calories come in so fast, and there's usually hardly any really good nutrition that comes with them. So the definition of a superfood is a food that gives us the lowest amount of calories possible with the highest amount of nutrition in it. Liquid calories usually aren't that.
All right, and what about, why do we have all these alcoholic beverages here?
You know, just because, alcohol is another one of those things that has a lot of sugar in it, so it kind of is like a fruit juice. And so we don't think about that when we drink alcohol, but they are usually filled with a lot of carbohydrate and sugar. And then ultimately, when we drink alcohol and we start to loosen up, what comes with alcohol?
Eating nachos.
Exactly. So it's a gateway to more calories. So if you're going to drink, you might choose a really good wine. Savor it, enjoy it, appreciate it. But if you really want to manage your health and your weight and feel good and vital, manage your liquid calories.
You also say the next mistake is trusting labels.
Right, so particularly when it comes to functional foods and nutritional supplements, we have gotten so far into this in our everyday life, and they're not necessarily really covered by the FDA. There's something called DSHEA, which gives these specific freedoms to put products on the market. They're not intended to treat dose, you know, cure any disease, it's also very hard to regulate them. So even great products that have label claims on them, they're finding that what's in them isn't what's on the label. So we have to be very careful, remembering that a supplement is ultimately that by definition. It adds something to our eating. It fills the gaps, not the other way around. Eat things that are healthy, that ultimately are natural by design, pharmaceutical grade, NSF certified, but be very cautious with this type of stuff.
And when it comes to fitness, do not go to extremes.
That's the biggest mistake we make. We go from one end all the way to the other. We don't work out, we go in the gym, we work out 6 hours. You know, this first week, our body's not ready for it. We're running in higher heel shoes, we hear the barefoot craze. We go down in barefoot shoes, minimal shoes, and ultimately blow out our Achilles tendon because we're not prepared for that. If it's too good to be true with anything in life, it generally is too good to be true.
All right, so moderation is key.
Moderation is key.
All right, David Jack.
Thank
great.
You.
Good to see you as
Thank
always.
You.
Thanks, David.